Hi guys, myself Shubham Sharma, and in today's video we would be discussing about re-level Android development test. So basically, if you have good command on app development, then you may proceed for this test. This test is recently launched by re-level, so I have decided to make the video on it so that it would be helpful for you. If you haven't watched my video for re-level front-end and back-end development test, then you may click on the I button above. The CTC offered through re-level Android development test is up to 25 LPA.
Oh my god! Wow!
In order to have the detailed analysis of it, let's move on to our screen. As you may see on the screen, that is Android development test. Then there is the instruction about like what is re-level examination and all. So basic details about it. Then the main part comes here. What do I need to do? As always, re-level Android development test also has 5 levels, or you may say 5 rounds. From first two, that is round 1 and round 2, summation of them, you need to score 150 marks. And in order to get a re-level profile and get the job through it, then you need to score at least 700 marks. So for the round 1 and 2, as it is described on the screen, it would be starting from 9:30 a.m. to 12:15 p.m. Then round 1 is basically back to basics. Round 2 is access your algo. Round 3 would be from 2 p.m. till 5:45 p.m. In round 3, you need to build an app. And in the round 4, you need to what? Provide the additional functionality to that app. At the end comes the round 5, which is face interview round. It would start from 6 p.m. onward. And the result of it would be disclosed after 5 days. After which, you may continue to sit in the placement. Eligibility criteria for the what? Re-level exam is that you may be either fresher or working professional. You must be actively looking for the job. You should be about 18 years of age. Okay, these are the basic criteria for it. How do you apply? Just go to the re-level website, that is re-level.com, and book a slot and just attempt it. Now comes the detailed part. So back to basics, that is a round 1. Its duration would be 45 minutes. Okay, and the marks allotted to it would be 150 marks. This round will consist of 30 questions where the candidate is tested on the soundness of their knowledge of computer science fundamentals. It would be from the core concepts of computer science like basic programming, DSA, concept of OOPs and Android fundamentals. And there would be again 50% negative marking for it. So be cautious before attempting any question. Then comes the round 2, that is access your algo. Duration of it would be 75 minutes. Okay. And the marks allotted to it are basically 150 marks. And in this round, basically you need to answer 2 questions. Then comes round 3, that is build an app. Its duration would be 90 minutes and the marks allotted to it are basically, as you may see on the screen, 200 marks. The candidates are required to code and develop an Android application. The candidate would be provided with a problem statement and the user story. Okay, basically you would be provided with the questions there on the scenario, or you may say the question or the task assigned to you so as to build an Android app. Okay, you need to follow those instructions and build an app according to it. Within 90 minutes, the candidate is expected to build the solution and also provide a screen recording explaining the code and functionality of the application he or she has developed. You need to basically record the video also after it, that is through the Loom app. Okay, you would be recording the video and submitting it. Then comes maintain the app. Duration for it would be 2 hours and the marks allotted to it are basically 250 marks. In this round, the candidate is expected to extend the functionality of the app built in the previous round. Okay, basically what you have to do here, app you have built in the round 3, you need to basically ask to add the functionality to it, make it more scalable. And what you must say, that is overall, you have to make an update of it, or you must say upgrade the app you have developed in the round 3. As specified in the round 4 question, basically see the instructions there, that is what they're asking for the update or what additional feature they want. And again here, you need to record the video explaining your code after this round 2. Then at the end comes the phase the interview. The duration of it is 1 hour. And the marks allotted to it are basically 250 marks. In this 45 to 1 hour interview, a senior developer leader will test the candidate ability to build products and work well with the product team in an organization. So they would be testing your Android fundamentals, your coding fundamentals, that is DSA part. And again, they would also be checking out your communication skills and your teamwork skills. Okay. So these are the things they would be generally checking out in the interview. So you need to be ready with your resume, okay, for the interview round. And how I get shortlisted, this part already I have explained, that is From the combination of round 1 and 2, you need to score at least 150 marks out of 300 marks. And from the combination of all the 5 rounds, you need to score 700 marks at least, so as to have a re-level profile. And which companies would be hiring through it? The companies which would be hiring through it are CRAD, RazorPay, 1MG, Zoomcar, Jupiter. These are the companies recently added here. Basically 100 plus companies would be hiring through it. And this is how your result would be looking out. Then comes the syllabus part for the computer science fundamental, that is round 1. The question would be from basics of programming, searching and sorting, basic data structures like array, linked list, stack, queue, advanced data structures like tree, heap and graph, OOPS concept, computer networks, database management, operating system. And from the Android development part, you would be asked on getting started with Android programming, using Android Studio for Android programming, activities, Android UI, data persistent, location based service, developing Android service and much more. These are the syllabus part. You may check it out. I will provide the link for it in the description of this video too. Now let us have an overview of the test instruction. I will also provide the link for it in the description. I especially urge to check the instruction carefully, because many students had personally texted me that their test has been cancelled. So be cautious, don't try to cheat, okay, and follow the instruction mentioned. So let's have an overview of it. Back to basics round. You would be assessed on fundamental of programming. Ensure you have laptop, basic requirement. Should be sitting in quiet environment. Close all applications. There would be previous and next button. You can mark your question for review. There would be negative marking for the round 1. Assessment is proctored. You have 45 minutes to complete. This is basically about the round 1. Then for the access your algo round, that is round 2. You are required to solve 2 coding questions.
No, God, please, no, no!
With each question having varying level of difficulty. Make sure you are facing the camera. Ensure you are in quiet place. Assessment is proctored. Okay, you may check all the details here. I will provide the link for it in the description. You have 75 minutes to complete the round. Then round 3, building an app. Ensure you have a system, that is laptop, in which the Android Studio is working fine. Okay, these are the basic requirement for the round 3 and 4. Because if your Android Studio is not working well, then how could you attempt? Then there are instructions, that is how you should submit the code for round 3 and 4. Okay, these are the instructions, you may check it out. Then there are instructions that how should you submit your video, that is the Loom video. Then there are the instructions for the face interview round. You may even take the screenshot right now also, or you may get the PDF through the link in the description also.
Nice.
Then at the end there are candidate professional guideline. Okay, you must also check this out. It is only 1 page long. Be available at least 15 minutes before. Ensure you have earphone connected with you. Okay, and camera is working fine. Be in silent place. Make sure no one is in your room. Dress up properly. Lighting should be proper in the room. Keep your answer brief. All rounds are proctored. If found guilty of malpractices, then your test would be cancelled out. And your entire test would be conducted in English only. You must follow them. So this was all about the Android development test by Relevel. And for your information, this video is not at all sponsored by Relevel. I have made this video so as to just help you. So I would meet you in the next video. Until then, bye bye.
Wait a minute, who are you?